100%. Dash just serve. Ready?
Ready.
Play.
Clijsters is on a 19-match win streak at the US Open. So the time she played before last year was 05 and she won it. It's pretty scary.
Serving a 15 love second serve.
You always see some errors from Venus, probably some outrageous errors, but she makes up for it usually with her winners. And a pretty good start here for Kim.
Quickly to 40 love. Venus Williams, winner of 7 Grand Slam titles, 5 Wimbledons, 2 U.S. Opens, not one the French or the Australian. 7 times to the finals here at the U.S. Open. Forehand, put on the board of 40-15 Clijsters.
40-15.
Clijsters, even the net ball, he pounced on it and hits a winner. One love.
Both game.
This is going to be about how well Kim concentrates, because we know that Venus hits so many big winners, but she also had some losers, and it's just a matter of, you know, really, when somebody's got as big a serve as Venus, it's concentrating on winning your own serve is probably even more important than trying to break her serve. Maybe
we'll have serve.
A little advantage serving first.
You have to get the nose out in front, huh?
Yeah, but as we saw with the other match, the previous match, the next serve stand is important. It's that big serve that goes straight at the body of the server. We've seen so many times the returner actually really struggling to get out of the way, both men's and women's. 130 miles.
Well, yeah, and I think sometimes what we've seen so far this week in the wind is, that's brought the ball in, even when it wasn't intended to be a body serve,
yeah.
Wound up being one.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. I mean, that's why it's a little bit harder for the returner to completely judge it, because there's been a lot of side wind or corner wind.
Mm-hmm.
And if they've got a bit of slice on, that's going to suddenly deflect into the body.
15-0.
Well, she's trying to show us how powerful she is at the beginning, 117.
Yeah, 112, 115, 117.
Fantastic touch. Kim doing well to hit such a good shot
30
back.
15.
What a good news for Venus to be coming in the match.
30-15.
My father's always telling her she's got to come in more. Sometimes she tends to lag back a bit. Funny, on the practice courts
40,
a couple
15.
Of hours ago, you had Rafa Nadal practicing, you had Venus Williams and Roger Federer, and usually Venus and Roger apparently like to practice on this a particular court, and Venus got there first, so Roger was not on his favorite practice court.
Ladies first.
Getting up there, 121, but missing.
Oh.
match against Venus, the more she likes it, but
40-30.
I think that obviously Kim has to. She can't throw in slow balls or something.
No.
Kim hits the ball so soon off the ground. She had such an early ball that she does have the ability to move Venus around and get it before she's get the ball back at her before she's fully prepared.
I also don't think she's bothered by the pace on the first serve. You know, a lot of other players are just overwhelmed, overpowered. But
right.
Clijsters returns the speed pretty well.
One game more. First set.
Being the piece. 5 minutes in.
Slightly disappointing that last shot for Kim because the ball slowed up. She had a chance to hit a winner, just missed. So, okay, this is a tough game. You've got your first game out of the way, a little bit of your nerves, and the wind is completely different, so a big concentration necessary. Has started off hitting at ground strokes very well. A few errors, but not bad errors.
Well placed. Clijsters.
30. Love.
Long and a hold at love. So Clijsters off to a powerful start on both ends.
2 games to 1. First set.
That's Venus Williams to serve here. 1-2. On serve.
That's the sort of shot that Venus sometimes gets into trouble with. It was a massive serve. Came back quickly with a little miss hit, a little short. She launched herself at that and couldn't keep it in.
1-20 serve.
Serve big right now.
Mm-hmm. Now again, if wind conditions are normal, I hesitate to say what's normal here, the wind would be behind her from this end. The flag up above, which we can't see from our view at the moment, can be blowing in the opposite direction. It gets down in this very deep hole and starts to turn around.
Fifteen all.
Interesting to see if Kim has more trouble with the second serve with all the spin on it, and that's been quite a difficult thing to handle with the wind, because the balls kick up and then the wind just messes around even more. It's hard enough for that one. Serve.
115 mile an hour that caused the missed time of Clijsters. 30-15.
Clijsters has had a few injuries herself this year. Little tweaks here and there, foot injury that kept her out of the French.
And again in the hardcourt season at Cincinnati. I think arrived here a few days before the tournament began because of a thigh or a hip injury,
yeah,
sometimes,
so
like
yeah.
A little hip, pulling muscle in the hip.
There and obviously
40-15.
The question for Kim Clijsters is to keep the ball in longer than Venus does, because eventually, if the rally goes on long enough, Venus will probably come up with an error. So, big challenge for Kim to do that with this sort of pace.
two here on serve in the first set.
Two games all, first set.
Yeah, Kim had to, she was playing the Fed Cup and they had a really good team. Justine Annan and her and Wickmeyer. And in the first match, she ran forward for a ball, felt something go a little bit in the foot, and she had to have about 6 weeks off, including the French Open.
Constructed there, coming forward to knock it off at 15 love.
15 love.
A little logo for the USOpen.org. A chance to remind you it's the exclusive online home for point-by-point live scoring and real-time draws. Visit the official tournament website for the interactive draw and real-time stats. USOpen.org. It's long, floated long, and.
That's where the wind is odd, because I think the other end is predominantly into the wind. It's every now and then the wind turns and comes from this side. Oh, that's a tough point. I mean, I was thinking how well Venus was handling that point.
30-15.
Kim comes up with something, one more. Just wonder, you know, Venus and Serena always seem to be so confident. And I wonder if Venus comes into this thinking, oops, I've lost to her the last couple of times, or whether she just doesn't take that into account at all.
Who knows, because they won't tell you.
No, nobody will tell you.
But the facts are the facts. Clijsters have beaten her the last four meetings.
40-15.
Yes, it's such a strange year. I mean, she really, you know, no problems at all, and then a couple of dire losses, one to Kim Clijsters in the final of Miami, and one to Jankovic in the final of Rome. In the quarterfinal of Rome, love and one, she lost that match. And then Madrid, she lost to Aravana Rosai in two comfortable sets.
A good hole by Clijsters. We're on serve at 3-2.
First set.
She's just ripping.
No. She seems to make a lot of sense, Kim, what she says after matches, too, about patience. Oh, what a good shot from Venus.
That's a great play. 15 love.
And how she has to be able to adjust her game. Something isn't working, and that was evident last year. Played a match against Venus and then struggled against Bartoli until she got her balance right in that. A good start for both of them.
Venus didn't go for that toss and blown. Turn the lights on here at 4:35. Cloud cover a little darker. Again, not threatening rain, but just it is darker, so we decided to turn the stadium lights on.
She just seemed doubtful about that whole serve, didn't she? She hesitated with the first serve and then looked a little jerky on the second serve.
See signs of where the wind is and what it's moving, but nothing telltale from our view.
I actually had more indication when I was watching from behind the umpire, and you could tell though how the ball was stopping at times on the side that Venus is.
Clijsters wide, 30-15.
The fact that it seemed to be coming from the other end, and so in the end you just have to have very good footwork and watch the ball very carefully in the gusty conditions. Oh, that would have been fun if that had made its mark.
Yes.
The rob was good over the backhand of Venus.
15-15.
15.
Got him excited on that one.
Still on serves and solid serving by both players here. We all.
I think sometimes she makes returning second serves very difficult for herself because she stands in so far. I mean, I know she does make quite a few winners off it, and I know it's intimidating that. It also makes some deep second serves difficult for her.
That's a good point. Frequently, she has to take a step back anyway. And forehand miss, Clijsters. No. Nope. Not good enough for sure. 15-30.
Yeah, you know, you can see when you come into the net, you want to do something, just drop it down, and it just didn't work that. So she did well to clear out of the way of that ball. It was nailed right at her, which is quite a smart place to hit it. A little trouble, a little opening of the door for Venus.
Seventh of the match, 11th errors, pardon me. Game with five at this point. 30 all. Good return, but it wasn't absolutely a high-speed rocket. Missed timing. His magic feet weren't moving. Deuce. From Venus, who just got control of the point, didn't let go. And even the sliding splits from Clijsters couldn't get to that one. Great point, first of the set.
It was a very different match this year from last year, where it was all Clijsters in the first set, all Venus in the second.
And there goes the first break to Venus Williams. 4-3 in the first set. 22,000 seats in here. It's just huge. It's the biggest in the world for tennis stadium. And you realize how high it is if you go up to that top row sometime and look down into the stadium. So Linda's got a lot of room to play around in.
You don't really get any concept of the height of the ball that they're hitting or the spin. From up high. Fun to watch from all places, actually.
Venus is just crushing her serves. She's been between 115 and 120.
Well, she's serving really well. I mean, and she's doing everything pretty well. She's playing unbelievably well as far as I can see. And Venus is getting rushed into trying a few sort of almost impatient shots. I know when somebody's hitting as hard as Venus is, you feel that you've got to match it, but the first thing Kim has to do is eliminate some of her errors. Less she has than Venus, but less Venus too.
Kim big serve 121. And while Kim Clijsters can handle the pace, she's just not been able to control the length of her return and placement.
He's just sort of looking down and making a motion with her feet, but she's got a muscle a little bit with her feet, but so far she's been much better than I would say she usually is.
Mm-hmm. 15 game point to go up 5-3 in the first.
It's just flying along, so disappointing game for Kim Clijsters.
And now the pressure on Clijsters here. She must hold, obviously, to stay in the set, but she's got to find a way to break Venus just to hope to get to a tie break.
And playing up the middle of the court in this match. And curious to see what would happen if she tried that, because Venus is just in full flow at the moment. She likes to run for the ball, hit it on the run. It's a ball that jammed her. Didn't like that one quite so much.
And you could do that by hitting up the middle of the court in the rallies. I take your point. Maybe she'll discover that's worth a try.
I mean, I know it's not really Kim's game. So watching Svonareva, she's so good at doing that and keeping her length and being very consistent with hitting up the middle of the court. Kim prefers to move her opponent around.
15 all at 3-5. It's out. Forehand there. 15.
Did hit a few a bit closer to the middle of the court to begin with until she got her chance 15. Really make an angle, and it's really worth watching from this angle sometimes and seeing her racket work on the ball.
So the hold for Clijsters. 4-5. Venus Williams will serve for the first set. So now Kim Clijsters has to find a way here to break serve. Stay in the first set.
Djokovic did, and then she started all over again.
Not a forward, and he misses. Out the speed clock now, the speed gun. That was 126. And it did, that one didn't look as fast as some of the others, so.
I'm just getting entranced watching how many times she's bouncing the ball, wondering what's going on in her head. But I think Kim needs to adjust to that too, because I think she's getting mesmerized also by watching Venus and waiting for her to finally serve.
That's another good serve that kind of popped back, giving her a chance to come in and put that away. She's got three set points at 40 love.
Venus Williams, an excellent first set.
So Kim Clijsters will have to find a way to dent the power of Venus Williams and her consistency, which has been excellent through the first set. They have to pick it up.
And again, going astray. This is a game of cheek. This is the side she must serve on. Must serve. From the side.
Forehand miss.
15-0.
I don't think Clijsters would probably, she's played her 12 times, that she'd probably try to start working the forehand, because that's the known, something that does go wrong in the ground strokes of Venus, it's usually on the forehand side.
Well, that's just what I was thinking, Tim. Yeah. In that rally, she was all about backhand, so I'm just wondering if she feels that she gets more backhands, plus she gets more backhands herself, too, if she hits to Venus's backhand.
Was
30-15.
And then the set. And on the left there at the cap is her husband, Brian Lynch. Played professional basketball in Europe, and he met Kim Gui playing for the team in Gui, Belgium, and that's her hometown. He's standing speaking to her mother at some function, and as I came across the room, the mother I wound up making the introduction. That's a good, well done. Good hold. The King Clijsters to start set two. Slice, but then she wound up making the miss. So that's the issue for her. She can't make any mistakes when she's got control of the point to get herself ahead in this match.
I think Venus is applying herself really well, concentrating and not making too many errors. Final when Bartley got to at Wimbledon a couple of years ago, Venus definitely took a little bit off her shots and made sure she kept them in and just stayed the course. Sometimes she just prefers, obviously, the preferred game for Venus is just to go nuts out there, pull as hard as she can, and they usually go in.
Backhand there from Clijsters, laser like.
15-0.
For some reason, called Venus flat-footed on this one. Looking the other way. Best shot she's hit today. That was not easy.
15-13.
The breeze is still coming across the court from my right to left on this. It was hard to find an opening and get that ball in.
An opportunity here at 15-30. Speed.
I'm not happy with that. Kim doesn't often show signs of total disgust, but she gets there, thrusts it up in the air, but can't control it.
Pretty all.
It's annoying when you make such a big effort to get to a ball and then you can't find the court. And that sliding she does on the hard courts.
For Clijsters.
She's been in any sort of difficulty. She's come out with a big bomb serve. Her serve 90 only, which is low for her.
First break point opportunity of the match for Clijsters. Big serve, block back, and
it does not go over. So that was what Clijsters was looking for, a little bit of help from somewhere. She got it from the net.
Got the space. Two gaps in the second.
It's discussing it. But yeah, I mean, she was. I was thinking 2 points before, she needs a little help. Venus isn't giving her any help. She's actually been hitting a little bit more smoothly these last couple of games.
Got it.
And she was going full tilted at hitting the ball through the first set, and I think that's where the errors come in. Here she's generating just as much pace by taking the ball early, losing the pace that Venus is giving her.
Long from Williams.
So that seemed like just a slower hit from Kim. I thought the same thing happened at Wimbledon when she played Justine Anna in the first set. She was trying to just hit the cover off the ball. But it wasn't a very good indication that, because Justine had that nasty fall and sprained her elbow.
Oh, a couple of errors from Venus Williams, and again, a little off pace from Clijsters, so she will probably stick with that. Jordy Love.
Yeah,
and back in this, and she's up 3-love in the set. Venus Williams winning the first set 6-4, but now at love 3 here with a break in favor of Kim Clijsters. See whether Clijsters stays with the new stroke that she showed of trying to keep the ball on the racket longer and not get into a pounding duel with the hard-hitting Venus Williams. Play. They've experienced everything each of them has to offer. And they've played fairly recently, once this year in Miami.
Ace
down the center line.
Oh, nice serve. Very nice serve.
The ace is now for Williams. Oh, another. Perfectly angled that time. Now she's taken all kinds of MPHs off on these 14. First serves and got two aces. She was serving 120s on first serve.
Yeah.
Let that one go to 120. A beautiful service game for Venus Williams on the board now in the second set.
That was a fantastic service game for Venus.
Second set.
In this match yet.
That's why it's moved along here. We've only played 51 minutes. Good shot again, not going for full power, but 15. Well placed.
Low.
Cord, Jordy Love.
For service.
Second serve and a nice strike of the
30,
ball.
15.
Backhand side. 15.
Good point here for Kim. She doesn't want to get into trouble on her serve again.
Well, backhand error out.
It's interesting, isn't it, Tim? You said before, you
48,
feel that Williams misses more balls on the forehand, and Russ has started to hit a backhand more and is breaking it down a bit.
Long, 40-30.
She seemed to just get up and serve before she really thought about that, and just want to instinctively hit that one.
That one up in the wind from well back with a good return, but now it's deuce.
And look at this bounce of the ball. Spinning, really taking it through, so she's got to do some serious thinking right now. And it's a good serve. And I can't help but remember the match that played last year when it got close in the third set. A really good serve at a vital point to win the match, and she did. Sometimes I think she doesn't want to settle down and do this the hard way and think each point out.
She's just in the rush mode here, going from first to second serve. That's out.
Pressure down there. Venus looking a little more relaxed at this moment.
Deuce again.
Suddenly I've got some juices.
Catching the floater and angling it beautifully with a volley.
This is the way, not necessarily the volley, but that's the way King really prefers to hit the ball, just go full tilted it, and she's got to restrain herself.
Another great point.
She's got more errors.
Advantage, Williams.
Well, you said that she had more errors than Venus, but she doesn't. She said almost exactly the same number of errors, and that shouldn't be the case if she hopes to beat Venus.
Break to Williams, and a flustered Clijsters in trouble now. Well, we're back on serve. Miss Williams breaking to get to 2-3 here in the second set. She has the set in hand. 6-4 in the first.
Seven.
the slice and paid off.
Mm-hmm.
Kim had a little help from the net when she broke serve. She's got to do the hard work out here. There just aren't any shortcuts today. The wind is too much of a factor. You see the total points 142 each, but you see him missing on some of the vital points. And this is all about the big points. And it's a bad game to give away from 40-15 up.
In fact, I think it's picked up some. The towel's moving on the chairs now. Showing us that.
Oh dear. She's not understanding it.
The left line, the ball has called out.
Either of them exactly what the wind is doing, and that ball, she might query it, but it's not going to change the call because it clearly out.
Indeed.
15-30. This Clijsters has two challenges remaining.
Again, especially from this end, is where she had the success of taking some pace off the ball. She should be trying that again in an effort to take advantage of this 12-30 start in the game. 124.
This has the hardest serve ever recorded by the women at 129.
125 in this match.
It is so hard to tell which way the wind's blowing because that definitely looked like the wind caught it from that far corner. It looks like it catches it from this end as well.
Two break points. Can't ask for more having just been broken. Would like to save these and roll this set. Yes, he does.
Mighty blow.
Great rally, but it was all about Venus Williams again. But still, one more break point. Sliding splits from Clijsters. The crowd always loves to see that. Got the ball back with that squash shot, but couldn't control the point. Another opportunity, though. Easily put away by Venus Williams. Deuce.
Played that point well. Terrific serve. It was all Kim could do to make the return, and she's under a lot of pressure here, although that was a pretty decent lob she put up. Right over here.
Second serve.
Mm-hmm.
that to the timing. So a third break point.
Yeah, that ball didn't come through to her.
Right.
Match. In fact, her second serve has been fine.
Clijsters to the line and Williams out. A break back and a break lead for Clijsters at 4-2.
And once again, Clijsters making sure she didn't miss the wall there. She's struggling with the pace, but she kept it deep. I mean, that you still have to do. You can't get away with anything if you dump short.
No, no, not with Venus Williams.
No.
A couple of strides will get there and crush it. Start for Clijsters. In love.
Suddenly a few more errors from Venus in the last couple of games. Well, that's well played. Venus actually, I thought that was quite a smart volley of hers, but it just so happened that Kim hadn't got anywhere near out of position, so she was just happened to be quite close to that.
And just enough on her shot in the windy conditions to keep the ball in. She turned it over enough and didn't hit it too hard. So she's got a 30-love lead in this game.
Right then.
30-15.
Is this her first double? The match?
Yeah.
Venus actually struggling to keep control of the ball when Kim has the wind behind her.
Mm-hmm.
Quite as solid as she was earlier on.
Game point for 5-2. Second serve.
This is a scary serve if the wind looks like at the moment it's gusting in from over the right shoulder. No better. Close ball on the baseline. Venus may be getting a little lucky with that ball that it fell in.
She was coming in behind that one too. Still a game point. Clijsters. 30-30. Two Clijsters in the second set, down a set. Venus Williams will serve to try and stay in the second set. Fortunately for her, she has a set in hand.
Last time she served from this end, she served three aces. Both of them. ruffles on the dress, fluttering, waiting for the game to calm down. Did have some wind socks out there that we could see
yes,
which
right.
way the gusts were going.
Right, we were talking about that. Even if they were just flags in strategic spots, small flags, keep in view, wind socks would be even better. Nice suggestion. USDA, no try.
We can't exactly go out there and stick our finger up and throw pieces of grass into the wind.
15-0.
That if I were.
I'm not sure. I think it's maybe touching. Very close. Maybe touching or not. Janet?
Venus doesn't really like
it's really
challenge,
the left
side
line. The ball was called out.
Gave the impression that it might have touched.
Touching?
Well, you see, you know my opinion
touching,
about
that.
Touching, no, I would definitely agree with him.
It's
well, he's totally wrong.
Yeah, so it's none of his business is my point. And it's her business.
But she asked his opinion.
Well,
he's
but
the umpire.
She shouldn't ask the opinion. And
yes,
he, well,
she
can ask, but he shouldn't answer.
I disagree.
It makes me crazy. I know you do. It makes it more
makes
fun to talk
you,
about.
Makes you more crazy that I disagree. She might challenge that too, but I do have differing opinions about certain of these things with the rules, because I can't remember, you and I were on the court when Serena had her outburst last year,
mm-hmm.
and I'm not sure whether we agreed that the foot, that a lot of people I spoke to, including listening to John McEnroe, awesome serve, thought that foot faults shouldn't be called, and they were
15.
A moron to call the foot fault, so to speak.
Well, I didn't agree with him.
No, I don't think you did.
No,
I think we agreed.
We did
we agree
agreed
on that.
Yes, and in fact, the foot fault thing is all about the players. Just stand back a couple inches. It's ridiculous that it should ever occur. What's the gain, especially with these big servers? I mean, if they're back two more inches, they're not going to be able to hit the big serve. It's crazy. So to complain about it being called, I have no sympathy for that at all. Same with Roddick in the match this year.
Oh, that was.
And he was going to argue, well, she was looking at his left foot and called it the right because it was on her right looking at the floor.
Stage right.
Yeah, exactly. And I think he knew that. And he was just trying to get his adrenaline going.
Yeah.
So hold for 5-3. Good serving by Venus Williams.
We'll find something else we disagree with. Since we agreed on that. So it seems that lately the far side has posed a few more issues for the players.
Now Kim Clijsters serving for the second set.
That's taken off.
15, no.
15 love. 5-3.
40-15 up the last time she served from
yes.
this side and let it get away from her kill. So got to pay attention to every shot and
15-0.
Just can't take go for too much.
No, and that was a good example right there. I mean, it's you know, there's some nerves at work here, I think, and understandably, even though she's a veteran player, it can happen to anybody. I mean, that was a nervous shot. She was just too eager and the point. Slapped at that forehand.
Now, my whole point always is if you go for a good shot, which means you
15,
go
13.
For a foot in or so on the line and you hit it just as hard but with a little more topspin and clearance in the net, margin of error, it might turn into a winner.
Mm-hmm.
But if you go for a winner and you're just a little off, it's going to turn into a loser.
Wow. I mean, it's like a one-game meltdown that happened to her last time. All Venus has to do is to keep the ball in play.
14.
She's smart enough and experienced enough to see that.
Seems that it's that end is the difficult one to judge the ball.
More reason to be cautious. Wow.
blew the ball blew right into her, but that was a poor shot. Poor game. Went by in a hurry.
So she keeps Venus Williams in this set. Five games to four now. Two breaks each. Missed it.
So I think Venus is probably prepared to come into the net on that side. I'm not sure that bowling is any easier than the wind with ground strokes, but it's putting a lot of pressure on Kim to come up with a good crossing shot. Well played, Venus.
Kim to her right and followed up in the same direction. Pretty low.
30 low.
That was a very good forehand. You hit the ball straight out like Kim did. You're not quite sure where you should go from that.
Yeah, well, again, same thing. She didn't need that good a shot there, as Venus was already moving the other direction.
Yeah, it was a better played point for Kim. So he kind of finally lost a shot.
30-15, Williams, 4-5 in the second, up a set.
From Kim is enough to cause the error.
40-15.
Game point, even things at 5-all. Venus Williams, number 3 seed, against the number 2, Kim Clijsters. Venus with a second hand. Down the center line.
Williams.
That's her fifth. Make it six. Six aces. And we're all even at 5 in the second.
She threw her arm into that serve. Well,
second set.
Two breaks apiece in that second set.
The momentum very much with Venus Williams right now.
Absolutely. 5-all.
Not slowing herself down, even you know when she's bouncing a ball, sort of a rushed bounce. Just where she wants, having to hit another ball, but well hit.
15-all.
It's getting pretty exciting, this match.
trying a little too much.
Yeah.
So shuffling her feet there, like she didn't feel she got in position to strike it.
The ball must just sit up and make you think you can hit it, and then it just isn't there. I'm surprised if they called that out.
Clijsters challenged the left faster line. The ball was called out.
Mind you, a long way away from that line, but it was quite well struck.
Interesting, good.
Touched a whole lot of the line. That counts as a winner.
30-15.
Replay the point.
Are they replaying the point? It really seemed to me that Kim had hit that
14,
ball.
15.
As we just looked there, well, maybe not. Venus is there. I thought Venus was already on her way back and that had been a winner, so we had to do that.
second serve. Game point for 6-5. Finish to that, 16-5 Clijsters. Venus now has to serve for the tiebreak.
Just don't think that Venus is taking as long as she is today to serve. I'm going to pause it about 8 times before she throws it up.
The Wall Street Journal did a whole story on the service and how many ball bounces there are, and comparing a number of different players, because it's been more noticeable, evidently, to some reporters that not just Venus, although she was in the one of the players that they were studying.
Beautiful
volley. So controlled volley there again with the wind factor. You know, it's so easy if you're going to try to make a real sharp volley that the wind can easily knock that 2 or 3 feet longer.
There was nowhere else really that Kim could try and pass her. It was the right shot and the right volley.
And the purpose of that story was mainly about the amount of time that it lengthens a match.
Yeah.
I think the bottom line, I'm trying to remember back to it, was that it could save 20 minutes if they stayed within the rules. If they just stayed within the rules of the time between points. Save 20 minutes in the length of the match. Oh, beautiful. Venus Williams backing up to handle that overhead. Dad like that.
Yeah, it's had a different look this tournament. He likes it when she comes up to the net.
Yes, he sure does.
He wants her to come up much more, and you can see why. Those long arms, there are not too many ways of getting it faster.
Dirty love, 2 points from the tie break.
Let's play for service.
Oh, you know, the point they were making years ago when the serve was dominating to such an extent was that all the concentration needed to be done between points, not while you were playing, because there was such a tiny percentage of the time the actual points. Once again, a good service game from this end.
40, glove.
Point from the tiebreak here in the second set. Miss Williams won the first set, 6-4.
Hold it, which usually doesn't appear. Watching. Big challenge for Kim is obviously she's going to try this point, but she needs to get ahead into the tiebreak, and how she's going to win points from that end. That's where she's been putting some pretty bad errors.
Another fault, Williams.
14.
That's your second, but tight moments even for the great players.
A lot of aces for her. A lot of free points.
Tiebreak, second set. In the tiebreaks this year, Williams is 5-1, Clijsters is 4-4. In career, Williams is 83-60, and Clijsters 47-34. So there's a clear edge to Venus Williams in tiebreaks, and much of it has to do with that huge serve. Clijsters will start at the first service point. She had a good serve and a 1-2 punch as well.
So she's cut short, very grateful to get a ball dumped into the net from Venus.
1-0, two service points will come to Venus Williams. First to win 7 points and must win by 2. Change ends having played 6 points.
You're thinking when you're returning serve in the tiebreak, it's got to be going to win one of these 2 points on their serve. You don't want to get so ambitious that then you're disappointed. So the thinking is, you know, at least if I win one of them.
Got the little mini break.
Yeah. Oh my goodness.
A double fault. The one all. 2-0, pardon me. 2-0 Clijsters.
Anything, but suddenly in the last few minutes, that last sort of a double there in the previous game, she suddenly got all edgy herself.
Service point for Williams. And second serve.
Good return of a long serve.
And the third double fault in the match. Clijsters on two double faults from Venus Williams. And I just gave you her tiebreak results for the year in her career with a comment that largely due to her great serve let her down here.
It's a good picture when you saw her serve and how she tends to bring her head down too soon on the serve sometimes.
Yes, it did.
It went over, or did it bounce and then go over? No, I think it bounced this side and then bounced.
Then bounced over. Okay. I didn't think it had gone over, and then the next thing I see it on the other side of the net. 4-0, Clijsters.
Learning the impassive look that her mother has all the time.
Yeah, you know the feelings going on inside, but she's still up a set. Points to 1.
4-1.
Still lies on that side of Kim's racket. And that was a generous error to give Venus back a chance. I mean, she was looking a little confused, being full zipped down.
Three service points to Venus Williams now. Crowd getting into it here. The kind of excitement to expect and want to see at the U.S. Open.
Thank you. Thank you.
Clijsters, I think, may challenge.
Gentlemen, Miss Williams challenged the left baseline. The ball was called out.
Well, I'm not too good today on these. I think that was
And it was out.
Boy. She hit it with such confidence.
Don't beat yourself up. The line umpire was also wrong.
5-1. Clijsters.
How well Venus has done on her overheads in these tough conditions. But I think it is actually a little easier to hit overheads in the wind than to hit good lobs.
5-1, Clijsters. Another service point for Williams.
Thank you.
Changed ends, having played 6 points. Second serve.
Let.
Piece of paper floating down into the court. I don't know what that told us about how the wind took that napkin. That was completely different from the way we think the wind's going. Yes.
6-1, Clijsters.
It's been a long time since I've seen Venus. Clijsters. Show such signs of nerves.
5 set points. That's her husband, Brian, in a blue hat.
Thank you.
Keeping the ball in play at 6-1.
I really thought that one did move. I mean, it really moved.
Yeah, it did,
body.
But nonetheless, I mean, 6-2.
Better backhand side.
No question. 7-2, and we're going to 3 here in this ladies' semifinal at the U.S. Open.
7-6.
Williams will serve to open the third set.
Yips on
the serve. Costly Yips getting the early lead in the tiebreak.
Three double faults in a matter of the game and a short tiebreak.
Love second serve. There with a big forehand.
Well, you can never relax against Venus, can you? And she keeps coming up with these big shots that you are so powerless to do anything about, and yet she gives you your little crumb and now and then, and just playing it for you.
Seven. 40-11 in the opening game of this third and deciding set.
She must be thinking somewhere. Boy, if only I'd served an ace instead of all those doubles right at the end, I'd be in the dressing room by now.
She backs away. Over again. It's so obvious that the wind is still not likely to change before the end of this match. Towels blowing from the backs of the players' chairs. An idea of what it looks like.
What did I say? Did I just say she was service back?
Well, you know, again, I'm sure there's some win factor in these, but nonetheless, that's five for her. She's only been won by Kim Clijsters. She's had problems of her own of a different kind here and there through the course of the match, but managed to get even here and force a third.
Yeah, well, if she makes up for those double faults with aces.
Yeah, seven of those.
Training in and dropping the ball in front of her.
Good.
Oh, that held in. Oh, get the umpire.
Yeah, Williams.
Well, that's a loose forehand from Clijsters. I mean, that was not a tough shot to hit.
First game.
So Venus holds. One love here in the third set.
And yeah, I think that if the wind was coming from her right shoulder, that ball would have just doubled its velocity from Venus. Good look at them. So two summary, 24 unforced errors, 19 for Clijsters, double false. Venus a few more for Kim. Well, you know what happened. It's set all and it's very close. Shots on Price's baseline that looked like they just managed to find the inside of the court.
Beautiful winner from Williams. Clijsters couldn't make a move on that. Love 15.
Catching.
Just her second of the match. To love 30.
Difficult when the toss sort of just drops in front of you as you've got to try and hit it.
Success with that slice.
15.
Hasn't used it all that frequently.
You have to be so patient with yourself in conditions like this because you are bound to make a lot more errors than you're used to making. And you just don't want to lose confidence in your shot making.
For Williams. From the heights of the Arthur Ashe Stadium down onto the court.
And 6 o'clock in New York. It's been quite a long day of tennis. Starting on this court with the men's doubles final.
Ryan, two tiebreak sets.
Know what you're supposed to do you, right here? I mean, if you don't keep going for your shots, the wind plays more havoc, but how do you keep going for them without committing errors?
Do second serve.
Second was always so difficult in the wind.
Ooh, got away with that. The pass lane was open. Point. Double or third, two of them in this game. Again.
This is really, in general, the easiest side to play from, but the hardest side to hit second serves from.
Advantage.
The premium on getting first serves in is huge.
Line and down into this huge stadium under our stadium.
So what's that from fourth? Third game point. One game point, one break point. Holds to one all here on the third.
One game all. Final set.
That really was a struggle. Both players really not very comfortable out there. Although I have to say, nobody's. That was a mini shake of a head and
yeah.
a mini frown. But
yeah.
both of them not giving too much away in the fact that it's in such tough conditions. Pretty valiant warriors out there.
Oh, absolutely. This is, you know, I don't know whether tennis is supposed to be fun even at the professional level. It's hard to have any fun out there in these conditions.
I agree. I mean, I take my hat off to them. We've had hardly anybody really moaning about it. They've said how difficult it is, but what they've all said is, you know, I've quite enjoyed the challenge.
And a double by Williams to start her service. Six of those in the match. Love 15, one all, third set.
But they always are having real trouble really being consistent.
Well, that ball was right in the wheelhouse. She was hitting it straight ahead, not trying to get to a sideline and not too long. And again, the most of her success from this side particularly is when she's taking something off the ball.
Yeah.
And she hasn't stuck with that. She's letting them fly, and they're literally flying.
Yeah.
Both of them.
Good topspin on the ball. Giving control of things. Despite the first volley that Venus has not hit well at all. Because she didn't close in.
Good topspin on that one, bringing it down low. 15-30. Little opportunity for Clijsters.
Big serve, 110. Hasn't been her fastest, and it's been 124 miles an hour, 199 and a half. Okay. Point. Well, that's so many big points in this net.
Oh.
That just completely stopped that ball.
Yeah. Again, you're thinking on the short ball there that, you know, you almost have to cut it. She's running forward and the ball's just going to fly.
Well, she did try to chip it, but I mean, the ball just stopped dead in its tracks. So suddenly you're sticking a racket
out
in front.
Yeah, no, that's fair enough. That's exactly what happened. Yeah.
I mean, I know there have been a few really embarrassing shots, not in this match, but from this side. Maybe when the wind was really even worse.
It's a deuce.
Deuce.
13th time that they've played each other. Clijsters rocks. And I'm sure that afterwards they're going to say, well, we never played in conditions like that. All the times we've played each other, you can kind of throw out, you know, what you know about each other and strategies and patterns and so on, because that's all out the window.
Oh, I think in the back of Clijsters' head, it must be a reason for her to keep fighting, is that she's won the last four matches. Shot that too. Make a drop volley off a high ball is asking for trouble. She gets away with it.
Great point.
That's the start, I think.
That's a good challenge.
Oh.
Ball. Too late now. Looked like it was long. Venus Williams makes that moot. 2-1 with a break.
She gets one. Final set.
Clijsters serving up 2-1 in the deciding set. Break. Luck 2-1. Venus Williams.
15-0.
On a serve from this particular end, and they could get away from her.
Not a good return. It was right there for Venus, and she dumped it in the net. Three games to one. Kim Clijsters in the third. Up a break. A reminder about USOpen.org. There's all kinds of reasons to go up there and have a look at it, including the great US Open's souvenir merchandise, which is available with international shipping. And you can see the Williams box showing a little tension and nerves themselves.
Even more than that, showing that they're a bit
chilly.
Chilly. Venus with her very straight hair, looking quite different, looking very elegant.
Ryan Lynch, I'm assuming he's both cold and nervous.
Yeah.
Rubbing his hands like that.
I think he's cold.
That's not.
You saw they sitting in the box just to the right-hand corner of Venus, and the hair was coming forward. I mean, I'm not sure which way, but Venus's ball catching her downdraft. Isn't it?
Oh, for sure. 15 joined us late in various time zones around the world. Earlier, Vero's Vonareva of Russia ousted the top seed, Caroline Wozniacki, in straight sets. Awaits the winner of this matchup in the ladies' final. First set, 32 minutes or something. They sailed through the first set, won by Venus Williams 6-4 with just one break of serve. Tiebreaker, second set.
Yeah.
And the ace from Venus Williams, her eighth, punctuates that game, and it's 3-2. Clijsters up a break.
Break up to two. Final set.
Clijsters, the defending champion, has to go three here to try to accomplish their goal, and that's just getting to the final. This is just the semifinal. One more to go for whomever wins this tournament. Here is Vonareva safely in, waiting for the winner. Clijsters with the break. Is that 15 love?
15 love.
And number six.
She's looking a little bit better in that rally, and then suddenly from nowhere, an error in the bottom of the net.
Oh, yes. A very Clijsters like point in good conditions.
Yeah.
He gets one here in the wind.
I start to feel timid. She's sort of taking, just calmed down a little bit. I mean, I don't think she's having any fun out there, but she's being more deliberate going up to the service line to serve.
Yes. And of course, you know, having to break up helps too.
Good return. Not her quickest serve, but as we've pointed out endlessly, it's very hard to hit good second serves from this side to win. So that one gave Venus a chance to clobber it.
Yeah,
slightly short ball of Clijsters, actually. Venus shouldn't have missed that one.
It's themselves clear the out for me. They for Jeremy, they turn. 14, 15.
Well, Nooney's even telling her why was out, but it was the wind. I don't like that. For the hold for Clijsters to 4-2 in the third set.
That just means Bogut for 2. Final set.
When we were watching the match yesterday, the umpire asked for the heater to be turned on, I think, in their seat, so they obviously are a little chilled up there. So Venus is going to have to really settle down in a hurry. Hopefully for her win this surface game and put some pressure on Kim in the next one. And nothing is for sure here in this match.
Boy, that's for sure. Long way to go. Lots can happen. We've seen it.
Great left-handed shot from Venus.
It was indeed a one-hander, left-handed.
And I tell you something, Kim had such a good chance to go into the net. Didn't want to. She's inside. Hits a great shot.
Yeah, I think she thought, you know, it wasn't going to be returned. So yeah, that's on her. She certainly should have come in behind that.
It's a mental error from Kim.
Look at Venus. What a shot. She's a two-hander, showing the strength of her left hand. And ball in play.
As you said, the wind is carrying it down there. Went right into the corner.
Williams.
Good points here from Venus.
Ace. Number 9. 40 love game. Doing her part here. Holding. About to. Easily, and then the next game becomes fairly critical.
Yep, the hole. Right back on Kim Clijsters.
The U.S. Open, it is 6-all, they will go to the title. Like the perfect conditions type of rally between those two women.
Yep.
We've seen that lots of times in their matches, and Clijsters comes out on top in this battle.
Yeah, a good rally from both of them, maybe both of them being a bit more careful, but you know, Venus either not moving quite so well or not quite so confident coming into the net. Maybe just not the right time.
Dean Love. Second serve. No, no, unfortunately for her, she nailed it.
Given half a chance, Kim just wants to go for broke. That's fine if she makes it. What a wonderful shot that is.
Pretty love. The hole here puts her a game away from the championship. Match against Donna Raven. Missed it. She definitely going for all of her groundies here.
It's the danger though.
30-15.
An inch long. I think she can if she makes sure, Kim, that she gets the ball in, she can expect to be more consistent than Venus at this stage. Venus looks a little drained and a little unsure of herself.
Doubles it.
Giving her so much help.
Well, we've seen this before in this match. So, and of course, that gives a little boost to whatever Venus is going through at the moment. 30 all as Brian Lynch, husband of Kim Clijsters.
Squat on this one. Oh, she didn't have to. Two double faults in a row. I mean, that will be fatal.
Great point, Williams. And Serena. Neither of them shows much. You know. Serena will show her emotions when she's playing, but when she's watching, she's a stone face. No, the camera's wrong. Oh, Clijsters. Knocks that one long. It was sitting four there, a little too eager, and the nerves again. Venus Williams with a break.
Well, I don't know. I suppose she had to go for it, but she sure went through too much. She took a head of the ball way before she made contact. So, not a pretty game from Kim Clijsters. Venus didn't have to do a thing in that game.
Now the crowd really alive here at Arthur Ashe Stadium. Venus Williams fans exhorting her, take advantage.
Kim just has to rein in her horses.
Set. Nailed the line. High risk shot. That's a little lucky that she didn't blow it up.
Well, I mean, even Venus gives a despaired look. Look at her.
Good.
Oh my goodness.
That is great stuff from Clijsters. She's doing better as a returner than as a server at this stage of the match.
Just hanging in there, that ball just drops at the last minute. And an open court, but how shaky must she be on that forehand?
15-30, good look here for Kim Clijsters, who was just broken in the last game. And double faults and bad shot judgment. Costly, putting Williams back into the set. Now she's got a chance here. 15-30. Already wide.
That was a wild shot Venus had to hit too. Well done. She got a first serve in, which was really key. Second serves, that's for sure. But how much can you take off your first serve and still be playing aggressively?
30 all. last first serve was 103, so more conservative.
There haven't actually been that many double faults, but they have come at fairly critical stages, like the tie break for Venus at the end of that second set. As for that last game for Clijsters. Taking so much time on the serve and hesitating because it just seems to be that she forgets how to serve. You know, maybe she should swing her arm through once in a while.
Great point, Clijsters. Good serve. Good. The break. Clijsters.
We've seen it all.
A turn of events here. Wind and all. She gets that ball up in the air and drops it in to go up 5-4. Kim Clijsters serving for the match. 5-4 in the third.
And the game means nothing.
That's for sure. And that, to her credit, was very well played, starting with a good serve.
Baseline saying, please get a first serve. I mean, you're all over the place, no rhythm.
Two great champions, great competitors. Two points away from the final in Clijsters.
Great distress in the face of Venus Williams. Not exactly any lack of tension in those faces.
Brian Joyce about to get his face shaved with his fingers. That's a good shot, and that's another good one back. Match points. She's been bold and brave in this set. Clijsters hasn't let up, not one shot long. It's the Williams box, her agent Bill Snow rolling the right, her mom, her sister.
A lot of commotion out here.
Second serve, 40-15.
Ouch.
Point. The championship lies ahead for Kim Clijsters against Vera Zvonareva. 6-4, 6-7. 6-4, Clijsters. Well, what an exciting and wild three-setter. Venus Williams winning the first set 6-4. Clijsters with an error-filled tiebreak wins the second set in a tiebreak and then comes back battling a break the up, and then with Venus Williams breaking back, the break at 5-4 by Clijsters, and she serves it out. I mean, it was high drama.
It certainly was high drama, and that's exactly the right word for it. Don't remember ever being that nervous watching either player.
Venus Williams quickly off the court. She must be terribly disappointed. It was a difficult day to play, a difficult match, and a huge disappointment for the former champion. Back her last time in 2001 at age 30, had a great tournament, the three seed, all the way into the semifinal. But Kim Clijsters now has the edge in their career series, 7-6 and 5 in a row. So we'll hear from her with Mary Jo Fernandez of CBS shortly. Now you can see more about how the wind is blowing here, because Mary Jo has her long hair flowing around out there. And let's hear it.
Kim, congratulations. Three very tight sets. What did it come down to at the end?
I mean, I just tried to just make the points, and whenever I felt that I had an opportunity to step up and just, you know, accelerate a little bit, I tried to keep the pressure on her. And, you know, I'm glad she made a few double folds in the tiebreaker there. And, no, I mean, it was a great match to play. Conditions weren't easy, but I think, you know, we played some high-level tennis, and it was a fun night.
You took off a couple years. You had your daughter, Jada, come back last year, win the U.S. Open. Are these the type of matches, the moments that you came back for?
Yeah, they are. Obviously, this is what you try to achieve. You know, I never expected, you know, obviously that I would, you know, come back in this position. And obviously, I was trying to do that, but it wasn't always that easy. But I'm glad I stuck through it and that I can live through these kind of moments.
What do you do now between now and the final tomorrow night to prepare to play Vera Zvonareva?
Talk to you, and then just, you know, go to the gym, just, you know, run a little bit, stretch out, and then do the usual press commitments, and then go home and have a good dinner and rest, sleep well.
Congratulations, Kim. 20 matches in a row, looking for your third U.S. Open.